We live in an era of images, digital photographs, high-definition television, computers connecting us to the internet and the entire globe. But what if you close your eyes? What if there were no images? Imagine a time when digitalization and screens couldn't just show us the people and places beyond our sight. Imagine a time when understanding and visualizing such images was left up to mere words and descriptions. Imagine the wonders of a radio. It was the 1920s when the public began to build and buy their own radio receivers, and radio broadcasting began to grow in popularity. As the decade rolled on, America approached the golden age in radio, and in Tulsa, Oklahoma, a young boy was constructing his own radio devices. Who was this boy? It is likely that 99% of Americans could share the bus seat with him and never know what a legend they had just been in the presence of. But a simple conversation starter with a stranger could have unmasked his identity. It's a voice recognized from coast to coast, the voice of the radio.
Hello, Americans. This is Paul Harvey. Stand by for news.
Born September 18, 1918, in Tulsa, Oklahoma, young Paul Harvey built radio receivers in his home. He made his debut into radio in 1933 when a high school teacher suggested that he work for a local radio station, KVOO. Eventually, he earned the opportunity to fill airtime with news and community readings. He later attended the University of Tulsa, during which he continued to be a KVOO announcer, and later became a program director. After graduation, he spent 3 years as a station manager in Salina, Kansas, and from there, he continued on his radio path, moving to Oklahoma City and then St. Louis. In 1940, he moved to Hawaii to cover the U.S. Navy and just left before the Pearl Harbor strike. During the war, he enlisted in the Air Force and afterwards moved to Chicago to take a job with an ABC affiliate, WENR, where he quickly became the most popular radio voice in the city.
And now, the rest of the story.
Both on and off the air, Harvey refers to his wife, Lynn Cooper, by what pet name? Doll? Pumpkin? Or Angel?
Wah, wah, wah. Girl, you're my angel. You're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps, you are to me, baby.
Paul Harvey met Lynn Cooper while working in St. Louis at KXOK AM, where she was the woman's news reporter. On their first date, Harvey not only nicknamed her Angel, but he also proposed to her. A year later, the two were married and became the beginning of one of the best radio teams in history. Paul and his Angel became business partners. Over the years, Lynn worked as Paul's producer, editor, writer, and director, including doing all four jobs when the two began News and Comment in Chicago in 1944. It was 1951 before the Harveys signed a contract with the ABC Radio Network for News and Comment, and he had his first national broadcast. In 1976, one of the show's most popular segments was The Rest of the Story and became its own airing.
And now, page two.
What is odd about Paul Harvey's name? Harvey is not his last name. It is not his birth name. Paul is his middle name. Born the son of Harry Arendt, Paul Arendt eventually chose to use his middle name when on the air, creating his on-air and known name, Paul Harvey. His father, who was a member of the Tulsa Police Department, was murdered when he was 3 years old during a car hijacking. The assailants were never caught, and this piece of Paul's past stimulated his high regard for cops and anyone in uniform. The name Paul Harvey Arendt is more commonly related to Paul Harvey's son, who has also made his mark in the radio world. It is his son who writes all of Paul Harvey's The Rest of the Story pieces, which share little-known or forgotten facts about famous figures. Nobody really knows where these stories come from, and is often questioned whether or not they are completely true. Many believe his son will be the one to take Harvey's spot upon retirement.
And now, page three.
What honor have both Paul, Lynn, and their son all received? Radio Hall of Fame? Business Person of the Year, really cool radio person. Harvey was inducted into the Radio Hall of Fame in 1990, followed by his wife in 97 and his son in 2001. Paul Harvey's list of honors, awards, and recognitions span nearly everything. He has been named salesman, commentator, person, father, and American of the Year. He's won 11 Freedom Foundation awards, and in 2005, he received the Presidential Medal of Freedom.
And now, page 4.
Within his broadcasts, Harvey is known to segue or transition randomly into song, impersonations, product endorsements. I am fiercely loyal to those willing to put their money where my mouth is, Harvey has said. Beyond being known for his dramatic pauses, intonations, and folkiness, Paul Harvey is often noted for the way he transitions from his stories right into commercials. And in typical Paul Harvey fashion, his style actually keeps much of his audience from tuning out the advertisements. In an age of jaded consumers, Paul Harvey's ads sound like word-of-mouth advertising from someone you can trust. His delivery is inviting, and even though a lot of products seem targeted towards senior citizens, he makes the message so inviting that I wind up listening, wrote Jason Lee on the blog site FLIR Creative. I have never been able to sell with anything other than left-brain logic, Harvey told Mark Fisher of the Washington Post. Some of these television commercials now are so cute, you have no idea when they're over or what they're trying to sell. I have to believe in, I have to use, I have to be enthusiastic about everything I sell. Pushing 90 years old, Paul Harvey is not ready to walk away from the radio stations just yet. In 2000, he signed a 10-year, $100 million contract with ABC Radio Network. Believe it or not, only a few months later, damage was done to Harvey's vocal cords, leaving him without a voice, the essence of who he is to the American public. He was unable to return to the newsroom until August 2001, but has been going strong since. I have never seen anything ever on television that matches the pictures painted on the mirror of my mind by a really good wordsmith, Harvey said, adding that there's an explosive quality to radio that just does not exist on television.
Now you know the rest of the story.